Dear friends, I am Parvinder from West Highlander and I welcome you all in this video about Masters in Australia with low IELTS and academics. This video would be of interest to students who have done their bachelor's degree and students who have a bachelor's degree with some work experience and are looking forward to study Masters in Australia but do not meet the direct entry requirements of the program. In this video, I would be speaking about the course options for these students. So friends, keep watching for complete information. To get admission into a Masters by coursework program in Australia, there are two basic requirements the applicants are required to meet. The first one is of academic ability. The students must have a bachelor's degree and the minimum percentage of marks required is from 55% to 65% depending on the section of the university you have done your bachelor's from India. So this is the first requirement. Now this percentage requirement may be more depending on the university and the course you wish to pursue. The second requirement is of English language requirement. To get admission into a master's program, the students are required to have a IELTS band score of overall 6.5 with no band less than 6 in any of the 4 modules of the test. These are the two requirements the applicants must meet to get direct admission into the Masters by Coursework program in Australia. Direct admission into a Masters by Coursework program may not be possible if you do not meet any one of these requirements. Firstly, I would be speaking about the course options for students who meet the academic requirement, that is percentage of marks requirement, but do not fulfill the English language requirements, that is of having IELTS overall 6.5 with no band less than 6. Let's say that you are a student who has got IELTS band score of overall 6.5, but in any one of the 4 modules you have 0.5 less. That is, in any one of the 4 modules you have got 5.5 band. So you do not fulfill the direct entry requirement of English language. The option for these students is to opt for an ELICOS course or a foundation program. So before enrolling or commencing your main master's program, the students are required to do an ELICOS course or a foundation course, the duration of which is of 10 weeks. So this is the course options for students who do not meet the direct English language requirements of getting admission into a master's by coursework program. Another example may be of a student who fulfills the English language requirement but somehow do not fulfill the minimum percentage of marks requirement. For these kind of profiles, the students may opt for a pre-master's program before commencing their main master's by coursework program. The duration of this pre-master's program may be from 6 months to 9 months. It depends on the requirement of the students, which is assessed by the university. So this is the course option for students who do not fulfill the minimum percentage of marks requirement to get admission into a master's program. Once you get admission into your desired master's course, there is a GTE requirement of the university which the applicants need to fulfill. If you fulfill the GTE requirements, you get unconditional offer of a place with which you can apply for your visa. As a part of the GTE application process, the students are required to send a well-drafted GTE statement. In this statement, the students must mention that why have he or she chosen to do this particular course, how this master's course is relevant to their previous work experience and academic history they have, what is the purpose of doing this course, what are the career outcomes they expect to have once the completion of this course, why did not they decide to study in their home country or some other country. These are some of the points which the students must mention in their GTE statement. Along with this statement, the students are also required to send to the university the funds they have for their support of their visa application. Once the students have cleared the GTE requirements of the university, they can start their visa process. There are certain visa requirements the students are required to fulfill to apply for their application. The first one is of having a COE. COE is confirmation of enrollment of studies. the students need to pay a certain amount of fee to the university, and the university issues a COE which the students need to attach with their application. Another requirement is of having an overseas student health coverage. This is very, very important, as if you do not attach a overseas health coverage, your visa application may be refused. The duration of this overseas health coverage must be of the duration of the student visa applied for. The students are also required to submit the documents that they have funds for the 12 months of their tuition fee stay in Australia. The students may deduct any prepaid amount of fee they have sent to the university. The students must also submit evidence that they have travel expenses of Australian dollars 2000 for along with their visa application. Along with this, the students are required to submit all of their academic documents, their work experience documents, if any work experience they have. So these are few of the documents the students are required to submit as a part of the visa application. Friends, I hope you find this video useful. For any query you may have about your study in Australia, please contact West Highlander. We are a team of experienced and expert counselors who can help you with the process. Thank you.